A big celebration in Montreal last night as Justin Trudeau celebrates a Liberal win and the start of his second term as Prime Minister. Richard Southern joins us now. And Richard, you were out in the field last night. Both of us were for election night coverage. And you experienced a bit of a different side of election night.
I might have had the choice assignment. You did a great job, no doubt about that. But I want to show you what I had to eat last night.
As did you, my friend.
Thank you, my friend. Okay. But, you know, usually at these nights, you've been through a lot of them, there's a hall and there's a place for the candidate to speak. But I found myself at an all-you-can-eat Asian buffet on Rexdale Boulevard last night. Look at those spring rolls. And look at those chicken balls, Mark.
Lovely.
Yeah, those Singapore noodles going down nice. So this is where Renata Ford had her election night party. And when we walked into this Asian buffet, there was nobody there, no supporters, just the media sitting up in the dining room.
All the more food for you.
Absolutely. She was running for the People's Party of Canada. She was hoping to serve up an upset. She didn't. And after I had my dinner, I asked Renata if she's going to run again. Take a look.
Rob didn't win the first time, and, you know, we might be back to the polls in 2 years if it's a minority government. So we'll be back, and we'll try again and see how things go.
Yeah. So, Renata, you're going to run for office again, is what you're saying?
Of course. This is not over. This is just the beginning, actually.
Under this party, under the People's Party?
Under the People's Party of Canada, of course, with Maxime Bernier.
So as far as the vote differential went, Mark, the incumbent Kirsty Duncan won with 26,100 votes. Renata got 1,183, although she did finish ahead of the Green candidate in that riding. Was there an all-you-can-eat Asian buffet at your particular location?
No, there were some veggies that were set out for the media, so we were very thankful for that.
Mark didn't put on as many pounds on election night as I did, I don't think.
Let's turn our attention to the other side of the pond, shall we? And what's happening in France. Is it the Olympic flame or an ad for a dating website we're looking at?
Yeah, we're looking here at the 2024 Paris Olympic logo, which was unveiled already today. Its designers say it's a combination of a gold medal and Olympic flame and the symbol of the French Republic. But many others felt it looked like the Tinder logo, that online dating app. Kind of does, actually. Swipe left, everyone was joking. Others said it kind of looked like the L'Oreal logo.
Oh, okay, I see now.
You know, anyways, the Olympics, they are still 5 years away in Paris, but planning apparently well underway for the Games. I don't know why they got to unveil the logo so early, Mark, but there it is.
There you go. Apparently, there is some significance to the lips that people see in the bottom of that flame.
Oh, I didn't see that.
Some sort of historical reference to the history of Paris, something along those lines.
Too cerebral.
Google it.
Too cerebral for me, Mark.
There you go. New research has revealed the least fun age in life. I'm worried.
It's 45, Mark. I'm not going to ask you how old you are. It's 45.
Oh, I got to get out more.
Experts say this is the age at which all the joy gets sucked out of your life. How lovely. The UK's Office of National Statistics says people aged 40 to 59 were the least happy and the most anxious. There is a happiness curve, they say. You generally get a little bit more happier through your late 20s and 30s, but then it starts falling in your 40s, and the experts think that's because you're juggling so many responsibilities, perhaps having to care for both a parent and a child at the same time, and there's a work-life imbalance. So there you go, 45, Mark. But maybe once you get past it, you start to get happy again. So just that little midlife bump in the road.
It's all in how you approach it.
Absolutely.
All right, thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Mark.